Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see an example of how NMR might actually be used in the laboratory. On the screen, we have a reaction. You and your friend, who love to debate chemistry, disagree on what the product will be. Your friend says that NaOH is a good nucleophile, and when paired with a primary halide, it will do an SN2 reaction to give an alcohol product. You say that sodium hydroxide is a strong base that will do an E2 reaction to give an alkene product. To determine who is right, you both go into lab to perform the experiment and get an NMR of the product. Let's see the spectrum. Here is a spectrum generated by nmrdb.org. So who is correct? Is this the spectrum of the E2 product or the SN2 product? With just a quick glance, we can eliminate the E2 product. The E2 product should have alkene hydrogens, which appear in the 5 to 6 ppm range. The spectrum shows nothing in that region. Let's look further at the SN2 product. Keep in mind that NMRDB spectra do not show OH or NH signals. The alcohol product has a CH3, CH2, and another CH2. By integration, we see signals of 3, 2, and 2 hydrogens. Of these three, the most downfield should be the CH2 that is next to the alcohol oxygen, and it should be in the 3 to 4 ppm range. Looks good. Furthermore, this CH2 has 2 vicinal hydrogens. So this carbon, with its 2 hydrogens, should have 2 neighbors on this carbon. Its multiplicity should be 3 for a triplet with a ratio of 1 to 2 to 1. Perfect. We could analyze the other signals in the same manner, and we'd find they match our expectations. The product of the reaction is an SN2, not an E2. While sodium hydroxide is a strong base, it will do an SN2 on an unhindered primary halide. One final comment. It is a bit unsatisfactory that the spectrum is missing the OH, so let's add it. Alcohols appear somewhere in the 1 to 5 range. Let's drop it in at just under 3 ppm. It should have an integration of 1, it should be broader than CH peaks. OHs and NHs tend to be broader than CH peaks. For our spectra, we will assume that OH hydrogens, NH hydrogens also, do not act as vicinal hydrogens or affect multiplicity. We therefore show OH and NH peaks as singlets. That's it. We've seen how NMR data can be used to provide information to determine the outcome of a reaction.